Hi there, it is of course Nick Dutch, back on the camera again one more time, now doing the serious answer to the question that was posed to me in private message. The question was of course, what do you think of Ouija boards? Now obviously I provided a bit of a sarcastic response because predominantly because, you know, been around for a while, quite a few videos out there, many of them are Nick Dutch videos, you know, Ouija board seances, talk about the ideomotor effects and all the rest of that. You know, with some subjects, okay, you know, take into account the number of videos that are out there, just like, go to the nice friendly channel page, find the search facility above my list of videos, and search for stuff and watch stuff, you know, it's all there, it's beautiful. You know, but I know that's a bit difficult for some people, because that involves, like, typing in, like, words and stuff, and clicking on things, and that can, you know, be a bit challenging for some people. Anyway, the more serious response is right about now. I perceive the Ouija board as being an ideomotor device. The proper technical term for one of these things is called a talking board, not a Ouija board. The word Ouija is actually a trade name which has actually entered into common language, and it was, I think it was the Parker Brothers trade name for the device. Essentially, you place your fingers on the planchette, and one of two things can happen. Either the planchette can seem to move all by itself, which of course it is not doing. It is your fingers which is moving the planchette through tiny little muscular movements or jerks or whatever, which then moves the planchette in various different directions around the board. Or alternatively, you get a feeling that the planchette should be moving in a certain direction. This happens after an extended period of self-training, whereby you have done the equivalent of handwriting exercises with the Ouija board, like you sit down, listen to the radio or watch TV, and you just spend your time moving your, you know, moving your planchette around and just seeing whether you can spell out your shopping list, or the quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog again and again and again, or maybe just like you know, a line from something in Shakespeare or whatever. You just practice so your brain and your body gets used to the muscular movements for where all the various different letters are on the board itself. Okay, what you're doing is psychologically programming yourself, you're training your mind so that you're more able to work on a subconscious level to work out, you know, where all the letters are. So if there is like a message which is percolating around somewhere in your mind, it's more likely to come out on the board. Do I think that the Ouija board proves to anybody the objective existence of any form of spiritual entity or enables you to necessarily contact the dead? I would say that it is not objective proof. It is proof of the ideomotor effect, possibly, or arguably, one might argue, but it is not necessarily concrete proof at all. All we can say is the Ouija board is one of those things which is curious and interesting and exciting and good fun and can hold people together for parties on Halloween night and so on and so forth. And as a result of that, it's in fact really rather like groovy, okay? And people use it for self-exploration as well, because like, you know, just like people would do like dream analysis and stuff from a psychological point of view, they would also use the Ouija board from a psychological point of view, or they would do or they'd use any other form of ideomotor type device. Here is an ideomotor type device. It is called a pendulum. Alright, same ideas goes into it. You know, you train yourself as to what is a yes answer, what is a no answer, okay? And the small movements of your hands can actually help to create some kind of apparent answer. Now, since it does the, I mean, this is where things start to get a bit weird, because then we end up with this debate as to is there like, is it something inside yourself or something outside of yourself which is actually causing the pendulum to move or the planchette on the Ouija board to move? And it's all a bit weird and woolly. There are some people who say, no, there's no proof that ghosts exist. And there's some people who say, well, actually, there's been some strange things that have happened under some strange circumstances, so that proves that ghosts do exist. Whereas I just say that there's some strange things that happen under some strange circumstances. We don't have concrete proof either way, and I think you could probably find proof to support either hypothetical stance from the things you see and experience using the Ouija board and the pendulum. I myself prefer using the dark mirror because it's a damn sight more fun, much more spooky, and it's cool. But if I'm doing something for other people to see, like say I'm doing it for a YouTube video, then I'd be more inclined to use a pendulum type device like the one in this box that I've just shown you a few moments ago, or indeed to use a Ouija or talking board type device. There you go, that's the more serious answer. So, good fortune, God and or Goddess and or none of the above bless. Look after yourself, the devil will not come out of the Ouija board and start farting sulfur all over the place, so don't worry about that. Or at least if he does, make sure you use a very good like air freshener, and then your parents probably won't mind too much that there's this musty smell of sulfur and all your furniture has got burned by the fires of hell. Sleep tight.